Welcome to the James and Derek Cooking Hour. We are starting a new series of how to cook things. So we are going to teach you how to cook things perfectly. What's your cooking experience?
Yeah, my cooking experience, microwavable Eggos.
I like to make pizza dough, and so I'm hoping that that will help me a little bit. Pizza dough and bread have got to be the same kind of thing. Today we're going to make bread without measurements.
I made it one time with my girlfriend, and she did all the work, and I just like mixed it. So.
Well, if you can mix, that's it.
That's what I'm saying. How hard can this be?
So we're not doing measurements. We're going to eyeball everything, and then we are going to have somebody taste test our ingredients that are being made into bread. The first step is going to be proofing our yeast. Do you know what that means?
Nope.
So you gotta make sure the yeast is alive. I do know that. Okay. So we are going to put this in warm water and it should bubble up. And so that is how we're gonna get started today on making bread. So one thing I do know is that the water can't be too high or it will kill the yeast.
Put the whole pack or just a little bit?
You can do what you think is best.
I'm gonna put the whole pack.
I'm gonna put just a little bit.
Put a little bit of sugar.
Oh, because they eat that stuff. So it activates it.
Activating.
Ah. Ha ha. Yum. Oh,
eat
shoot.
Yeast.
I just hit myself in the eye with yeast. Is that?
It'll grow in your eye.
Wait a second. Sugar. I don't know how much sugar to add.
Just eyeballing.
That's what I'm doing. A bunch.
So the next step will be.
I'm getting it everywhere.
The dough.
I'm kidding. I'm getting yeast everywhere.
I can just. It smells like bread.
It looks weird. Like the bubbles don't move. Oh, I bet that's the sugar. They're eating it.
How much flour?
I'm going 2 handfuls. Or 3. I don't know. This is a big old pan right here. Oh, here we go. Boom. 3 handfuls.
Can't tell if this
That looks about right for me. I'm doing 3 handfuls. That didn't look cool.
We're on.
If it's too or not watery enough, I can just add more later. You can always add more.
You can always add more.
Always
you can't
add
take
more.
It
I know that's a bacon thingy.
Well, you're not.
I think it's going to be good. It's probably going to be the best bread ever made.
Whoa, this is going to be the best bread. Oh, I can't. How do I put my phone back? Hey, y'all, update on how this is going.
It's starting to look like something.
His is. Mine is not. Oh, maybe not. It just got stickier.
And then you kind of dust it, get it on your hands, that's what you need, flour.
Oh, that's what I should have done before I grabbed it.
Probably.
Dang. Well, hey, if you're cooking bread, use flour on your hands before you grab the stuff, otherwise your hands will look like this.
Or there's probably like 1,000 other videos on YouTube that teach you.
But this is
better.
The best one. They might do it better, but this is the best video. That looks good. This does not
look
good.
Mine's gonna be a little floury.
That's a lot of flour.
There's a lot of flour though. Something you're not supposed to knead it a lot to make it better, and something you're supposed to knead it a lot to make it better.
I have no clue.
This video would need to be edited very well.
Very, very, very well. Okay.
We could, just toss it in the oven.
Just as a ball?
Just as a ball.
So they used to do in the olden days. Back before, you know, fire was invented. These are starting to look like bread though.
I mean,
okay, I gotta get this stuff away from me. Get out of here. So, we're to this point where it now looks like actual dough.
Yeah. Oil my
Get
pan.
Olive oil now.
And we're gonna let it rise. I'm gonna put mine outside. Now, I saw on TV that you put a damp cloth over it.
You're putting it outside.
Well, you have to let it be in somewhere warm. Do you think it'll break it? Bake it outside?
No.
It's like 90.
I'd be worried about bugs.
That's why you put the towel over it.
Water makes it sticky. Just let your parents come home to a huge mess.
Don't clean it up.
Just go like this around. And make sure it gets real good all over it. That's what it looks like. Yum. Bread. Boom.
Mine might bake.
In the sunlight.
Mine might bake outside.
Oh yeah, there's yours. I don't think it will. We'll find out. But we know what we're doing.
Let's see how it's doing.
Hey!
That's bigger.
There is way too much olive oil.
Yeah! Hey. Look at there! Boom. Looky there. Alright, so now what you want to do?
Flop it out under the table.
Flop her out.
This is going to make the most delicious bread. So, I'm going to spray in my pan. Let's
wipe it down. Wipe it. You got jelly?
Yeah.
There we go. Looky there. Like it's supposed to. Alright, ready? Here we go.
Chuck it in. Alright.
Bake, baby, break. Excited that one of two things is going to happen right here. I don't know if you guys can see it. But Derek's is perfect right now, and mine is not. But they're still rising, so one of two things is gonna happen. Either they're both gonna rise, and yours is gonna be
like
ginormous.
Yeah.
Or they're like not gonna rise.
Like when you microwave a marshmallow.
And yeah, it blows up. And mine's just gonna sit there and be ugly. It'll fit right in. First look. What do you think?
Are you impressed?
It looks like it's cooking, but it's a weird color.
Well,
unless that's the black thing.
It smells like bread.
Yeah, it looks like bread. Does it feel like bread? Oh!
Almost a catastrophe.
Thumbnail right there. Boom. Oh. Hey. It's so hot.
Flipper.
Looky there.
That's an artisan loaf if I've ever seen one.
Boom. Alright, about to have a taste off.
Taste test. We're getting judged now by our superiors.
Will we get fired?
Will we get fired for wasting time or not? So we got three judges. We have Angel, Denise, and Miss Lisa.
Hi.
We are judging on sight and taste. So will you judge which one that you think looks better first?
This one looks better.
Okay.
Angel?
Yeah,
I would think that one because I like the
slice okay.
on the top.
Me
too.
Oh, okay.
All right.
Okay.
Now we're going to cut a slice.
Oh.
It looks fluffy. Looks good.
I also want to say we both went into this not knowing really.
These were no measurements.
So y'all made this bread?
Yeah.
We made it today. No measurements. We just poured in the ingredients.
Oh no.
I had scooped them out with my hands.
We have the footage to prove it.
Yeah, so
it's really hot.
He poured his flour and I scooped my flour to kind of measure. But they both turned out way better than we anticipated.
James's.
Yeah.
We want honesty.
Yeah, if it's the worst bread you've ever tasted, you gotta let us know.
No, I mean, it's just flour, water, and yeast. And sugar
I don't know
and
about
salt.
That look. Uh-oh.
It's just flour.
And water. And yeast. Could have drizzled a little honey. Oh no!
What? Tell us what you're thinking.
It's
very plain.
It's
and doughy.
It's chewy. Yes.
Chewy.
It's chewy.
Chewy's good, right?
Chewy. No, bread should not
That's
be
what
chewy.
I look for in all my bread.
No, bread.
Denise?
Doesn't have a lot of flavor.
Okay. Well, mine's probably almost the exact same.
You did use a different flour. You used bread flour.
All right, try mine. Again, they're probably the exact same taste. If they're different tasting, we don't know why.
This one feels fluffier.
So mine one's on the field.
They taste the same.
Okay.
Okay.
No.
No.
No. This one's not near as chewy.
But less.
Which
flavorful.
Is better. But less what?
Flavorful. It's more bland.
Okay, so now you have to judge which one tastes better. A
overall.
Or B. A or B, yes.
Mm-hmm. Taste.
Angel? First or second?
I'll take this one.
Okay, Denise.
Because that one's just
taste.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I'm going with the first one.
A.
Okay.
B.
Oh, you got me on
you
taste.
You got a tie. We got a tie.
So we need to find more people.
So, yeah. If we can't find more people, this was the first episode of the James and Derek Cook Something Without Instructions or Ingredient Lists. So leave in the comments what you want us to cook next. It could be anything in the world. And we will cook it for the next episode.